This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, anytime I want to.
Now we're cooking with evil guys.
What
the
voice of people must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crimes which are weakening America, I guess you will agree.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, welcome to Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay, this is Casey.
Hello, how's everyone doing today?
I'm sure they're doing fucking wonderful. Howdy to all you out there in the interwebs.
Yes, I'm doing great. Christmas is coming. Fucking love it. I love Christmas.
Nothing like a big fat man in a suit breaking and entering.
Yeah, and speaking of Christmas, our Christmas special's next week. Is it next week? Yeah.
Yep, next week we're going to have a very special guest for you, barring anything crazy happening, like an accident or an alien abduction. you're going to meet our friend Mark Hammer, who has to be one of the funniest human beings I've ever met in my entire life.
I hope I can keep my composure, because he just fucking... he had me laughing so hard one time, I had to go out for air.
Mark Hammer is an interesting human being. We'll tell a few stories about...
Yeah, and his last name actually is Hammer. Like, he told me that when he came over on the boat, his family were blacksmiths, and they didn't know what to name him, so they're like, your last name's Hammer.
I wanna be your Mark Hammer.
I love that song. It's a great song.
All right. So, today, we have a very special beer today. It looked good in the store. We have today Lancaster Double Chocolate Milk Stout.
Oh, man. Mm. I'm lactose intolerant, so I hope it doesn't have real milk in it.
They use lactose in it to make it.
Oh, really? Good, so I won't shit my fucking brains out.
Well, if this if this shit looks real jumpy later, it means Casey had to stop for a potty break.
We'll throw it up. 6.8% alcohol. It's not bad.
I love a stout. I'm not so sure about the whole chocolate milk thing, but we'll give it a shot.
Oh, yeah, it's the one from Lancaster. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, this is I think this is my first, like, chocolate stout. I know they make a lot of chocolate stouts, you know, but I think this is my first one.
All right, well, let's give it a try.
Ding dong.
Cheers. That's like an adult milkshake.
Yeah.
It's kind of good.
It doesn't, at first, I don't know about you, but at first I don't get a chocolate taste.
It's on the aftertaste.
Yeah, at first I get, like, I don't know. I got to hold on.
Try it again.
Lots of flavors going on.
At
first, it's like, it tastes like a lager maybe or something.
Well, it's got that stout roastiness and the maltiness. It's got the finish, though, is where you get that huge chocolate rush.
Yeah, and at first, it's really refreshing. Like I said, it's like a lager or like a something light. And then just the taste punches you right in the dick, and you're like, oh, man. That's good, though. And here's the thing. Like, I've never liked stouts or, like, porters and stuff, but more and more, like, doing all this, I'm actually really starting to like porters.
You see, the darker beer is my favorite. I like that. I like the malt far more than I do the hops. I like hops, but malt has more of a complex flavor to me.
Yeah, I gotta try it again. There's just so much flavor.
Yeah,
like,
there's a lot going on with
this. I've never wanted to try a beer so many times.
It's really good. I wouldn't want to drink a lot of them.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. Wait, is it a stout?
Yeah, it's a milk stout.
Oh, yeah. Dog fucking says stout.
Right, I mean, God. It's really sweet. There's definitely a lot of sweetness going on.
Yeah. That's really good, though. I like it. I could have a couple. Yeah, like you said, I don't know if I could drink it.
I wouldn't
want
to drink a bunch of them. Like, I'd have a couple and then move on to something else, but it's good.
I've had worse. And, like, you know, I like it. I'd drink it again. If I was to rate this, I'd give it... I'd say 4 gas station sandwiches out of 5.
3.5.
3.5.
3.5 gas station sandwiches. It's average. I wouldn't get excited about it.
Yeah, you definitely had better stouts.
I've had better stouts. Absolutely. I've had better beers in general, but it's definitely good.
Yeah.
It's certainly not something you'd be disappointed in drinking.
Yeah, it's just an orgy of flavor. Like, I had to keep tasting it because I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
There's a lot going on there.
After that, let's get into some military discussion.
Oh, good.
Yeah. So I was just cruising around on the internet, and I saw this. I can't tell where it's coming from, who made it, or what's going on, but... basically, it's plans for a new kind of tank. And I wouldn't even really call this tanks. I apologize again. We have another video to the people with the podcast that are listening on like iTunes and Google Play. But we're going to start linking the videos that we watch on like Twitter and stuff like that. So
yeah, that reminds me. From now on, yes, we'll definitely include links in the show description. But also, if you want to see things that are going on, follow us on Twitter.
Yeah.
We're at Hostile Opinions. That's a great way to see what we got going on. We'll make sure we always link things in Twitter as well.
Yeah, because I just seen this. And show a picture of it here, right here. It's a video, and it's sort of a long video, so I have some key points here just to... It's some people say it's America. Some people say it's Russia. Like the title says, Future Unmanned Russian Solar Power Tank.
A solar power tank? It runs off electricity?
Yeah, just it's crazy. Like, I watched this, and I'm like, if this is American, like, I wanted to slam a Budweiser on fucking a bald eagle after I watched this. Like, it's just crazy, but... We'll show a little bit of it here. Blow this up just a tad. But what's going on here, basically? At 50 seconds, this is where we're going to play. You got these things that basically come out of the back of a plane. They're these huge solar panel things.
Okay.
And I'm like, this is a tank? And they drop them out of the plane. And I'm just like... I don't see the tank part.
Is that live footage or is that... That looks like a render.
It's a render. It's okay. Made in, I don't know, probably 3D Max or Maya, something like that. And they basically fall to the ground.
Yeah, okay.
Skipping a little bit ahead here to about here. So it lands. It pops up. It sucks the parachute in. And I'm like, that's weird.
That alone is pretty badass.
Yeah, I know. And I'm just... It's sort of boring at first. I was like, where are they going with this? And then it camouflages itself.
How do the solar panels work if there's grass covering it?
That's the thing. There's different modes of this.
Ooh, like the music.
Yeah, I know. America. So basically, they blend in until they're ready for use. I guess this is like a sleeper stage for them. Going a little bit ahead here, it just, you know, basically shows you that they're camouflaged or whatever like that. Then it gets real interesting.
this music, man. It sounds like it should be in an 80s action movie.
Yeah, I just want to, like, Roman war, like, cutting people's heads off. So, yeah, they're blended, but let's give a little head here. There's some enemy tanks that come in. And the enemy tanks are coming in, and basically how these things work is all through drones.
Okay.
So the drone flies in and spots the enemy tanks, sends a signal to these tanks... or solar tanks, or whatever the fuck you want to call them. And that's when the camouflage comes.
Nifty.
So they send a sensor, and then this happens.
Okay. Well, that is overkill.
I know. Did that even work?
I have no idea. They're like giant fucking bullets.
I know. They're tank shells. Like...
This looks like the newest Command & Conquer game.
I know! Like, look at that!
Huh. I don't know exactly what to say to that.
I know, either do I. Like, I just... I don't... When I was like... I think I saw this on a random Facebook page or something like that. And I'm like, if this is real... Like, whoever we use these against are fucked. like, just that propulsion thing of whatever the fuck you call it that would just grab a shell, shoot another one, and just, like, that's fucking crazy.
That's pretty badass.
I know. And there's, like, people we're talking about, they think it's the British that originally did it. This, like I said, this one says Russia. People are saying the United States did it. I don't fucking know. But holy shit, dude. But doesn't that look like something from a video game?
Yeah, it literally does. Like I said, it looks like something from the newest Command & Conquer game.
Yeah, I just hope that, you know, fucking that's not real.
I don't know. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, man. So, yeah, I think my friend posted it on Facebook or something like that. I was like, what is going on? I don't know. I don't even think it's possible. Like I said, when those things come up, there's nothing like really hitting the primer for the shell.
I think I saw something like
hitting really,
it, but it was. I don't know. That whole thing was fucking ridiculous.
I know.
Those motherfuckers.
Oh man, I just hope you know that's on our side. I hope that's on our side. Oh, man.
I don't know. We could pull a Hillary and drone them.
Yeah, can we drone those people?
We just drone that, yeah, dude.
But watch it. Before you know it, we'll probably be able to buy those on Amazon at some point. That's like drones, man. They used to be like something like, you know, high-tech.
A real drone, yeah, is something different than a quadcopter.
But you know what I mean. They used to be expensive. They used to be hard to get. Now you can just fucking pick them up at, like, Walmart.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I just thought it was interesting to show that.
That is pretty interesting.
So what do you got for us then?
Well, for my next thing that I was going to talk about, I was going to save this for next week for the Christmas special, but then I realized the Christmas special should be fun and not horrible.
Oh, great.
We're gonna learn about a real-life Grinch who stole Christmas.
Oh, great.
Why don't you pull up the video here? We got a little bit of a video. It's really the audio we need more than the video here, but... This twat waffle of a preacher, and I use the term loosely because the guy was a security guard for a nuclear plant who actually got fired because he said too much dumb shit and they took his security clearance away.
So this guy, because I've seen this before.
Yeah,
this
you guys probably have all seen it, but in case you haven't, we'll play
it
anyway.
This guy was in control or around nuclear stuff.
Yeah, he was in charge of keeping crazy people out.
Because when I first watched this video, this guy looks like a Mountain Dew drinking mongoloid flipperhead. Flipperhead. Like, you can tell he's not all there.
Well, let's just go ahead to the video here.
Okay. Hold on, let me blow this up for a second here. Blow this up. I didn't mean that.
Yeah, after that last video. All right, so here we have...
Hi, it's Pastor Dave Grisham here for Last Frontier Evangelism. And today we're at the mall in Amarillo, Texas. And we're going to tell
insane.
The children mm-hmm. here today the insane. Truth that there is no Santa Claus.
So this twat waffle decides to ruin Christmas for a bunch of kids.
Jesus died on the cross to pay for their sins. Jesus was born in a manger 2016 years ago. So here we go. Mm-hmm. We're going to tell them the truth.
So we're going to trade one fairy tale for another one.
Folks, my name is Pastor David. Kids, I want to tell you today that there is no such thing as Santa Claus. Santa Claus does not exist.
Can you believe this, guys?
This is about Jesus. Jesus was born 2016 years ago. He was born in a manger in a small town called Bethlehem.
And I mean, this is Amarillo, Texas.
Bethlehem.
The man you're going to see today is just a man in a suit.
Oh, hey, skip ahead a little bit.
Like Santa, oh, man. Santa
this
does is not
you
exist.
Get this. This guy Santa's keeps going on about real. This for a while.
Doesn't someone and confront him or something?
Yeah, some angry
Christmas
fathers come
about.
Up.
Talking sure. Back. You understand me?
You back it up a little bit.
Sir, don't put your hands on me.
Go on. Quit talking his mess. You understand me?
This mess. That's awesome.
I got my kids over there. We don't need you coming over here blabbing whatever the hell you're blabbing.
I'm telling
go
the
on.
Truth.
You see,
no Santa now, go.
I'm not leaving.
Okay, you can kill it. Okay. Everybody gets the idea. And this guy here, he so rightly deserved one of those fathers to beat the crap out of him. But
I know, I'm surprised they didn't.
They, like decent human beings, showed restraint.
Yeah.
Unlike this piece of shit.
Because the thing is, like, Christmas is a time to relax. Like, people, Americans are really hard work, and they work their asses off, and Christmas is a time to relax.
And who the fuck cares if you want your kids to believe in magic?
I know, like, and
you know what? You know what they're scared of? They're scared. People like him are scared of the fact that one of these days, their kids are going to wake up and realize, oh, there's no Santa Claus. Oh, there's no Tooth Fairy. Oh, there's no Easter Bunny. Well, but Jesus is real, right?
Yeah, I know. It's just... And that's the thing, dude. He doesn't look all that. You can tell by his eyes.
Dude, like, the guy is out of his mind.
I know. You can tell by his eyes. He's fucking nuts. He's like looking like, oh my, like I'm gonna tell the truth.
You know,
like,
and people
where's my Mountain Dew?
People like this have this ridiculous, overblown idea that they are somehow the moral high ground here. I'm sorry, ruining a bunch of kids' Christmas is not the fucking moral high ground. I don't care how you look
I know.
At it.
And the thing is in the Bible, you know, it does say spread the word of Christianity. You
yeah,
know,
but
to
it doesn't
wanna,
mean be
I know,
a dick.
And that's the thing. It doesn't say anything about fucking this. This is retarded. And this is what I think people read that and they're like, oh, I got to spread the word of Christ. No, you know, maybe you can if people want to hear it. Like, what's that saying? It's like. Religion's like a dick.
You can be proud of it.
Yeah.
You can be happy you have one, But don't go waving it around in people's faces. And don't try to shove it down my children's throats.
And then people wonder why fucking Christians are getting a bad rep these days. And it's just fucking assholes like this. Like I said.
Now, for the record, I reached out to this guy. We sent him an email trying to see if he would come and tell his side of the story on the show today. He has not responded to us. So
That's because no one watches us, but whatever.
Yeah, well, I sent him an email. We sent him an email. We're waiting back for a response. He, as of the time of the recording, has not contacted us. Which means instead of having his side of the story here, maybe he has a legitimate reason for this. I can't imagine what it would be.
He's fucking brainwashed.
But you know what? Since he didn't respond, I guess we're going to have to Nancy Grace it and base all of our information off of the little bits and pieces we see on the news. And what I can see is this guy's a fuckhead.
Yeah, he's a fucking retard. Like I say, the two best forms of brainwashing is religion and government. This is the main... Right. It's just ridiculous.
And the fact that this guy thinks he's somehow better than the you know, the other people are sitting there screaming Allahu Akbar and screaming about their religion. I'm sorry, just because you pray to a different invisible man than somebody else doesn't make you better than them.
I know, and it's like this one family episode, Family Guy, they were talking about that, and there was these two Christians or something, or no, it was before this, but there was these two guys, and he was like, hey, I have no reason to hate you. I'm no better than you, and we're, you know, humans. And the other one's like, yeah, I have no reason to hate you. And then some guy walks by and he's like, did you hear about that super baby that was born in a manger? And they both whip out knives and just start stabbing each other. It's just,
I have no problem with religion. I consider myself a Christian too, but I don't sit here and try to like fucking shove my shit down anybody else's throat.
I know, and like this guy's just, I don't know if he's bored, he ran out of fucking Mountain Dew to drink, I don't know.
How do you think you're a good person if you go and ruin a bunch of kids'
Christmases? But that's the thing, he thinks he's right.
Oh yeah, you know what, I'm sorry, you're not.
I know, like he's just, don't, and this is being a dick. This is being a dick. This isn't doing any good. It's just pissing parents off. Like I said, parents are probably working overtime to pay for these kids' Christmas, and they're like, oh man, the kids are shutting up for 5 fucking minutes. You know, they're going to see Santa. And then and just like, you know, it's supposed, Christmas is supposed to be relaxing. It's not supposed to get people all crazy.
It's supposed to be fun.
Yeah, like fired up. Like, holy fuck, man. I mean, this guy just needs bitch slap.
I'm shocked that the parents in Amarillo, Texas did not bitch slap him. Although I commend them highly for actually taking the high ground here.
Because Texans don't fuck around.
Dude. No, they do not.
Like, they took on a whole country by themselves, sort of. So, like.
Yeah, so, I mean, this guy has a history of being a jackass. So let's talk about this dude a little bit.
Oh, he has a history. Great.
Oh, yeah, he has a history. This is not the first time. I mean, this has gone viral, but there's been other things that this jackass has
done. I know, because I've heard about it all day yesterday.
Like, he tried to burn a Koran in 2010, and he had the Koran all soaked with kerosene. Now, I mean, this is exactly it.
What color Koran was it? Sorry, I had to. I saw the moment.
The Islamic holy book of the Koran. You know, and yet again, here he is. He thinks he's all better than these other people who pray to a different invisible man than he does. He sits here and he douses in kerosene, and this skateboarder guy comes up and snatches it out from behind him and says, dude, you got no Koran. And runs off and turns it into one of the Muslim preachers. Is that the word?
Idea.
I don't know.
I have no idea.
But one of the Muslim preachers from a local mosque. So there was somebody decent in that story, and I got news for you. It wasn't the preacher.
Nah.
Quote, unquote, preacher.
Yeah, and it's like you're fucking basically saying, hey, my religion's more peaceful than yours, and you use violence. Like, mm-hmm.
I'm going to burn your holy book, you know. The guy's group, he has like two groups that he's associated with. I think he disavowed this one because they've gotten such a bad rap, but one of them is called Repent Amarillo, and the other one's the one that he announced himself as being part of on that video, which was The Last Frontier Evangelism. Well, so anyway, Repent Amarillo is actually considered by the Southern Poverty Law Center to be a hate group.
Oh, great.
Yeah. They filed a lawsuit against the city of Fort Worth. They filed a lawsuit against the city of Fort Worth because the city violated his civil rights for shutting down this protest that he was doing against a pride parade. You know, like, way to be a dick. And they held...
And this is the thing. You read the fucking Bible... Jesus was hanging out with fucking prostitutes, homeless people, whores, like,
you know, and this jackass, you know, he led this protest because Fort Worth, I believe it was Fort Worth, elected an openly gay lesbian, I believe, an openly lesbian mayor. So he was just having his fucking meltdown about it. Well, I'm sorry, gay people exist.
I know. Like,
they
get,
do.
Get the fuck over it. Like, they just do. Who gives a fuck?
You know, do you really care that badly about what's going on in somebody else's bedroom?
I know.
If so, I think you got a problem.
And that's the thing. Like, I do think it's weird that a man wants to fuck another man in the ass. But it's not my problem to judge people for
it. It's not your like, it's not your place.
Yeah. Like, I've talked to... I was friends...
I got news for you. I don't give a fuck where you stick your dick.
Yeah.
I don't care if it's man, woman, cow, bowl of soup, pudding that you, you know, stuck between the couch cushions once as a child because you had curiosity.
Okay. I gotta try that later. What was that? Let me write that down.
Yeah, make sure you put it in the microwave first, warm it up a little bit, room temperature.
Oh, man, that's great. But, yeah, I was friends with a gay kid in Florida. He was 17. He lived above us, and he was really cool. And
so he was a top.
Yeah. And like, we were talking one day, and I was like, so when did you decide that you were gay? And he's like, to tell you the truth, pussy's disgusting. And like, it was weird to me because I like pussy, but you got to think on the other side, pussy is disgusting to him. And I think, you know, buttholes of a man is, so it's like,
I mean, if you want to blast somebody in the fart box,
yeah, if it feels good
by
to
all
you,
means.
Go the right the fuck ahead, dude. Just go right ahead.
You do you, I'll do me.
Yeah, and that's the thing.
I might not agree with you, but you have the right to be you.
And that's the thing. We didn't judge each other. We didn't judge you. He was actually really mature for his age. He was a really smart 17-year-old kid. He was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, you know, he didn't like the way vaginas felt. I didn't like the way other men's buttholes felt. I didn't hate him for it. No. I'm just like, oh, that's strange.
You got the right to do whatever you want to do. And you even have the right to be like this jackass. But if you're going to be like this jackass, then we all have the right to call you out on it.
Yeah, exactly. It's like the Kaepernick thing.
I mean,
you can do what you want to, but you're a fucking dickhead.
Yep. And considering there's a whole metric ass load of ways to get in contact with this particular fella and let him know exactly how you feel and call him out on it. I'm not saying that you should, you know, harass this man, but if you want
harass this man.
But if you want to, all of his publicly available and on the internet information, including his phone number and oh so professional email address of gspanishwolf@yahoo.com.
What is a gspanishwolf?
No idea.
That sounds like a cologne in the 80s.
But his Facebook profile, his wife, who is just as bad as he is, Facebook profile, his wife's Instagram account, the homepage for the Last Frontier Evangelism, the email address and the Facebook page and phone number for Last Frontier Evangelism will be posted in the show notes down below if you feel the need to let this guy know exactly what you think of him.
But don't, because we're not conducting that.
But we don't condone doing it. But all that publicly available information with a simple Google search is available in the comments below.
Watch this guy get attacked.
Well, he's not. You know what? I'm surprised nobody beat his ass. But don't use violence.
I know that's like just I'm saying. Tell Texas don't fuck around. Just don't.
Here's the deal: the guy was exercising his right of free speech. Well, there's nothing wrong with us exercising our right of free speech by calling him a fucktard.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Like, all those kids are just like fucking so confused, and they're like, "What is going on?" And it's like, if a kid wants to believe in Santa, let him fucking believe in Santa. Who gives a shit?
Yeah, dude, we all believed in Santa. We all had a good time doing it.
And to tell you the truth, I don't even remember when I found out he was fake. Like, I didn't even care. Like,
other kids at school probably told you. That's what happened.
Yeah, like, that's just whatever, dude. Like, who
you know what, though? From the parent's perspective, I kind of can't wait till my kids stop believing in Santa.
Yeah, so you can just be like, stop lying about it.
No, it's not even that. It's just I want some fucking credit for all these gifts I'm buying.
Oh, man, that's I didn't even think of that. You're probably like...
Spending all my money on there, like, the fucking fat man gets all the credit. Well, Santa gets all the credit, you know?
Ain't stretching it there, but...
we always say, like, you know, three of the gifts are from Santa and the rest come from us, but still, the fat man gets credit.
Nah.
I want credit. I bought them Kinects for you.
Kinects.
Yo, those are badass.
They still make those?
Yeah, dude.
I'm still a Lego fan. Legos for life.
Legos are good, but they're fucking expensive.
I know they are, too.
I was actually at AC Moore with my wife a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
And we were kidless, which is rare. So we were kidless, and we were at AC Moore. And believe it or not, they have some decent toys there. Amanda got him a microscope, which I think is a really cool thing to have. I had one as a kid. There's nothing cooler than looking at the slides. It sounds nerdy, but it's really cool for a kid.
Everyone's a nerd in their own way.
Yeah. And they had Kinects there for $10. So I'm like, yeah, threw it in the cart.
Fuck yeah. Actually, I
love building shit.
Yeah, I've never used Kinects. I've always played with Legos.
Legos, Kinects.
And not Mega Blocks. Mega Blocks are not Legos. I don't fucking care who you are. I hate Mega Blocks.
Yeah, let me get that Duplo, dog.
Duplo. Mega Blocks are shit. I don't know how many times when I was younger, I got Mega Blocks because my stepdad was a cocksucker. He was like, they're cheaper. And they were like missing pieces. Some of the shit didn't even stick together. I think I found a used condom in one of them. Like Mega Blocks, just give up.
You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
Just give up, man. Just give up. You'll never be Lego.
It's kind of like the GoBot Transformer debate.
Just let it go.
They're making a sequel to that.
Of course they are. You know how much fucking money?
They made all the money.
What'd they say? That was the first movie, I think. I don't know if I'm correct on this, but I'm pretty sure I heard that. It was the first movie that was still out in theaters that came out in DVD at the same time.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. It was the only movie to ever do that. I'm pretty sure.
They should do that now.
Nah, exactly.
With the way, you know what, the way things are going right now, especially with, like, Netflix and everybody being able to binge-watch an entire season.
Yeah, I just found out a week ago that I thought Netflix did it, like, they released every episode. No, they released the whole fucking season. I never knew.
Yeah, they released the whole season at once, which is great and terrible at the same time.
I know.
They just released the whole second season of Fuller House. Yeah, I like Fuller House. Fuck you.
Fuck yeah, I do too, man.
It pings my nostalgia vein. But anyway, they released Fuller House and... Dude, I'm telling you, man. Jodie Sweetin, she did a photo shoot for Maxim.
Yes.
I know those titties are fake, but damn, I'd like to shake that surgeon's hand.
Oh, man. Yeah, we actually have a picture over here. Let's look at this. Yeah, look at that. Mm.
Stephanie Tanner, my, how you've grown.
She looks good for doing a lot of heroin.
Yeah, she was a fucking train wreck. Scroll down. There's more nice pictures.
Oh,
there.
Is there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think it was heroin. She was doing not she good was, at
everything,
all.
Meth.
Yeah, I think actually she did more, a lot of math. Ooh, look at that booty.
She got that body karate.
Oh, body karate. It's an onion ass. It brings a tear to your eye. Oh, she looks good. Yeah.
She does look good.
She looks good for fucking... See, why did you have to show the family picture?
We don't need the family. Keep going. There's
why,
more.
Why do you have to show the family? Like, I'm sort of like half, you know, rager right now. And then, yeah.
I mean, she's had plastic surgery. She admits she had plastic surgery.
Yeah, these are photoshopped to hell.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah. Like, anytime, like, you see shiny skin like that, it's photoshopped to fuck, dude.
So what?
I know, but I'm just saying. I'd still fuck. Oh, God. Well, she has no... they probably edited that out. I was going to say, that thing has to be beat.
I was like, what are you insinuating? She has a dick?
No, there is no moose knuckle there whatsoever. There is.
Looking like an Arby's roast beef sandwich.
Yeah, they edited that because if she was doing drugs, she was getting the hole beat up.
Oh, man. It's kind of like her on TV dad. You ever suck dick for marijuana? I don't think so. I still cannot believe they took a filthy ass motherfucker like. Like him, and made him like the saccharine, sterile dad on the show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude. That's the thing. Like, his stand-up is so wretched.
It's filthy.
Oh, my God. The first stand-up I ever seen him was, he was talking about when his kid was just being born, and he couldn't wait to have a cigarette, and he fucking forgot his. So he was talking about asking the doctor, yo, if you give me a cigarette, I'll let you finger my newborn. Like, that was the first thing I heard from him, and I'm like, oh, funniest home videos, like, what is going on? Like,
I don't
childhood.
Really,
I
don't really like his stand-up just because his delivery is really, really jerky.
Yeah, he's a big fan of Rodney Dangerfield, so that's where, like, he...
He's got that jerky delivery. Yeah. It's not my favorite, but the guy's funny.
Oh, yeah, he is, but it's just, I don't know, like, childhood...
It's filthy.
Just childhood ruined. Because I had some pastor tell me that Bob Saget isn't real.
Bob Saget is a myth.
Oh, man.
It's all about Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was born 2016 years ago. Dinosaurs aren't real.
The earth is only 2,000 years old.
Yeah. The earth's flat.
I can't do it anymore.
I believe in God, man, but you take everything from the Bible face value, and you're just stupid.
I know. That's the thing, dude. I just can't take. People are so fucking stupid.
Like I said before, I've said this countless times, and I'll do it again. You know, you want to take everything for face value out of the book that you want to read, but, you know, there's all sorts of other dumb shit that you ain't going to listen to, like, you know, the shellfish thing. You're not allowed to eat shellfish.
You're not allowed to wear artificial clothing like polyester. Women aren't allowed to wear gold, pearls, all sorts of fucked up shit.
It's all open to interpretation.
Yeah, it was some guy that was probably bored and was like, I'm going to write a book.
it's like, come on, man. You can believe in a higher power if you want to, or you're free to not believe in shit.
Yeah,
you're still cool with me.
Fucking get out of here, dude.
But you know what? The second you start stumbling upon my rights and my children, that's when you become a dick.
I know, and that's the thing, dude. I could see if he was...
All the contact information is posted below in the show notes.
You're out for blood. I've never seen you out for blood so much.
I have kids. And I know,
and that's
the thing.
That
would piss me off. So.
Well, when you first sent me the text message, I misread it, and I thought you said at our mall.
No, I don't know what to do. I like to think I'd be a tough guy and beat his ass, but I probably wouldn't because I'm a big pussy.
I would have took his kneecaps. I would have got those solar powered tanks and just fucking wrecked him. Damn near killed him.
A little slow on the rim shot there.
Yeah, but you know, this actually goes into our next thing really quick. Speaking of stupid people.
Okay, all right. I love stupid people. Let's hear it. Yeah. Stupid people.
I got here for us just dumb shit on Twitter. It's just dumb fucking shit. And this is the thing that everyone has to remember. Everyone has a voice now. So you're going to, you know.
Including us.
Yeah, I know.
You're watching us for entertainment. I don't know what to say about you people.
I got to take a swig of this beer for this because this is just great.
Oh, this must be good.
So I have six just random tweets I found. Some of them have to be trolling because, people are this stupid. But the first tweet here we have is a girl named Jennifer. And she posts about a gun. And it reads, hashtag AK-47 stands for automatic killer. 47 bullets per pull of the trigger. Much deadlier than an AR-15. Hashtag gun sense.
I'm probably supposed to be laughing right now, but I don't know if any of that's true because I don't know shit about it.
Well, AK stands for, what's his name, Kushtov or whatever, the guy that made the gun. I forget his first name.
Okay.
40
something Russian.
Yeah, I forget what 47 stands for, but AK is his name. It doesn't stand for automatic killer.
Couldn't prove it by me.
I know, but it's... and it's what makes it is the hash gun sense.
It has to be satire. She can't really believe that.
And that's what I'm saying. I don't know. And that's what I'm saying. Take these with a grain of salt. These I just think are just fucking like hilarious.
Use a dumb bitch.
Yeah. Well, that's one of them. The next one we got here. Well, I like his Twitter name. His Twitter name is Eating Ass Next Door.
Well, when he gets busted, he'll know why.
Yeah. And this one's great. Who in the fuck is Paul McCartney? This is why I fuck with Kane. He's always Kanye, whatever. He's always trying to put on new artists.
Yeah, he's not that stupid. Is anybody that stupid?
Well, I remember actually seeing a lot of this when he covered this song because someone else tweeted. They go, I don't know who this Paul McCartney is, but Kanye just made him famous. And I'm just like, oh my God.
You guys ever hear of a band called the Beatles?
Anybody?
Love me do.
I don't even really like the Beatles, and I've heard of this.
Blasphemy!
I know. Don't get me into it. I've even heard, I don't know. We won't get into that. That's another But
Let
eating ass next door, yeah. Listen to some Beatles. Educate yourself.
Wings? Live and let die? Yeah, <I
know. laughs> this is great. It's so weird how the majority of pet-o-files of files are teenagers.
Pet of files.
It's so weird how the majority of pet of files are teachers. Oh, man.
It's called spell check. It's built in.
Does Twitter have spell check?
Your browser does.
It does. I just, and this is the thing, like, going in from the Santa thing, everyone has a voice now. So people can just, you know, talk about pet of life or
pet of files.
I'm just blown away.
I don't know that the majority of pedophiles are teachers, though.
I know, and that's the thing.
Although, like, I was going to say, if I was going to want to look at stare at some, you know, kids,
yeah,
probably teacher would be a good profession to get into.
If I want to stare at some kids, I'll just shoot a load in the girl's face.
Whatever happened to being a Boy Scout troop leader?
Yeah, I know.
I just pissed off a bunch of Eagle Scouts.
Oh, that's okay. I was about to say a joke, but I'm not going to.
Yeah, that's all right. There, somebody's already pulled their underwear up over their head a few times.
Nah. All right. Here's another one. His name's Christian. While y'all are acting like the world just now getting messed up, what about slavery? The Hall of Cost. Pick up a book.
Yeah. You might want to follow your own advice there, Christian.
Pick up a dictionary. They're cheap.
Hall of Cost.
Doesn't that sound like a discount, like, grocery store? The Hall of Cost.
Fantastic.
Oh, yeah. So I think I got one more here. No, I got two more.
Oh, good.
Let's go to this one here. Speaking of the Hall of Cost. This girl is very excited to take a selfie at Auschwitz.
The sad part is she's trying to starve herself to look like the residents there.
I know. Like, I don't know. I think that's rude.
Yeah, kind of desecrating history a little bit.
I know. I love the face, too, the little emoji she has. She's so happy to be standing around death.
Speaking of Auschwitz...
man, it's funny.
Or desecrating historical sites. Did you hear everybody's all mad at Jennifer Lawrence right now?
What'd she do now?
She admitted that she scratched her butt on one of the ancient stones in Hawaii during the filming of the Hunger Games. The second one, I guess, probably.
Who gives a fuck? That's why I like her. She's nuts.
Well, everybody's all mad, and somebody got all pissed and called it her Amy Schumer moment.
What, like, she's playing Barbie? She can't put the fork down?
Like, everybody just wants to make a damn crisis out of everything.
I know, and that's what I'm saying. And that's the point I'm trying to prove here. Everyone has a voice. You just gotta just, like...
Everybody should, though. Yeah, that's the problem.
Just take a stick and just push it away. Or get some doom spray. Like they do
right in the face.
Yeah, like they do in Africa. But, we got one more here.
I don't know. She can say whatever she wants.
I know. Oh, man. I drink her bath water.
You know, we used to work with a guy years ago who always said I'd drink a gallon or piss just to see where it came from.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Oh, man.
Not Jennifer Lawrence, but he would use that term in general.
Yeah, like, I don't get starstruck, but if, like, I was in an elevator and Jennifer Lawrence came in, I probably wouldn't be able to.
No, fuck yeah, I get starstruck.
Yeah, I really don't. I don't really care, whatever, you know, fuck celebrities, but I don't know. If you
could fuck celebrities, you'd be in a better
like
shape.
Like her, I'd be like... Like, I'd have to control myself.
Fuck celebrities. If you fuck celebrities, you'd be doing something more entertaining than a podcast.
Yeah, that's true. All right, the last one we got here from 2801. How did Beyonce's album go number one in 100 countries when there are only 7? Asia, Africa, Antarctica, Australia, North and South America, and Europe.
What?
And that's the thing, man. I don't think they teach this shit in college anymore. I really don't.
I don't think that person made it to college.
I think they're too busy, like, just teaching about, like, fucking, you know, shaved head feminism and shit in college now. And then, like, I just don't.
There's only 7 countries.
I say, what?
The fuck you mean?
And that's just the tip of the iceberg. There were so many, but I only wanted to do like 6 because I just, you know, wanted to keep it a little bit short, but Jesus fucking Christ.
The only thing short in this equation is the bus that they were in the school on.
I know, dude. Where are your water wings and helmet? Oh, man.
That's actually giving a bad name to people with legitimate mental issues. These people are just fucking stupid.
Oh, yeah,
they're not even disabled. They have all the world's ability to go out and learn stuff.
I know. And, like, people make fun of rednecks and shit like that. But, I've never met rednecks this dumb.
Do you see this? This is a cellular telephone.
A cellular telephone.
It runs Android. This thing here, as long as I have a Wi-Fi connection or a mobile connection, allows me to have at my fingertips all of the world's knowledge. All of it. It's all available to me. Everything.
Is there pedophiles? Of files.
All of the world's knowledge is contained in this device right here.
That's our first t-shirt, pedophiles.
I thought we were doing the...
I just have so many ideas, dude. Like, I want them all. I want them all.
We gotta make merch.
I know, we do.
Other reason than we want to wear them.
Yeah, we got to get viewers first. But
fuck viewers. We don't need viewers. We love you all.
Yeah. We love all 2.5 of you.
Well, we're up to 47 now. 47 subscribers.
Yeah, we got 47 subscribers. I'm actually surprised by that.
We're almost halfway to 100. We need 100. Would you like share with your friends, people? We need 100.
Yeah.
So we can have youtube.com/openlyhostileopinion instead of youtube.com/UXA743.
Yeah.
Six.
Share it with all your friends. Share in all 7 countries.
Hey, I suppose we should take a moment to shill our bullshit for a second here before we can move on to the next subject.
Oh, man.
So if you haven't checked it out already, as you see in that little icon over there, you will see Patreon. Patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. You can pledge as little as $1 an episode, and that helps us make these shows happen. We can get better stuff. Better equipment. Maybe we'll actually have a camera that we don't look like fuzzy assholes.
Yeah, I know. We just have bad camera fucking luck. Like, we just...
What we need is a really good webcam so that we can see things decently.
We've been trying everything, and it's just not working at all.
No, so if you guys could, like, contribute a little bit, we're poor, man.
Yeah, we're poor. We can't afford the R.
A little bit, every little bit helps. Over that way, my hand is in the vicinity. You'll see a subscribe button.
Oh, this one.
If you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button there, and... there's a little bell icon. If you hit the bell icon, you'll get notified when we upload new videos. So hit that. Let's see. Is there anything else? Yeah, follow us on openly or on Twitter at openly. No, I'm sorry. It's at hostile opinions. Damn it! I'm fucking up today.
Fucking up in all 7 countries.
Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Google+, whichever your social platform of choice is. You can find the links down yonder. And and if you're listening to us on iTunes or one of the podcatchers, leave us a rating. That helps us out big time. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah, and just one more thing. I'm going to be making an update video here soon. I don't know when I get time to do it or whatever.
The state of the OHO podcast.
Yeah, the state. The state of the pet of files. I can't do it.
You about to get a coffee shower.
I know. And we're just going to talk about more things. And then, I'll probably make it in the next couple of days. I am working on another... Excuse me, Jesus. Jesus, Santa isn't real. But anyways, I am working on another stories through MS Paint. So it just takes a little bit. We'll get that
Fantastic.
Out for you. And that's just look out for the update video and follow us on Twitter and all those social things. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. So onward and upward. Do you have another
one? On steed. No, I'm all good.
Shall I?
Yeah. Shall
Is
I?
It my turn? Yes. Fantastic.
Indubitably.
Wonderful. you're going to have to bring up some images here that we have an imager account.
Okay.
I wanted to talk about this last week, but we didn't end up having time. So let's go ahead and bring it up. So what happened is an office worker officially got told off for having a can of beer at work.
That motherfucker.
Yeah. So he had this tall boy sitting on his desk, and one of his other coworkers who couldn't mind their own fucking business reported him for having a can of beer at work. So guy got hauled off into the HR department and... got written up for it. So, what it turns out is if you scroll down there, you can see the actual write-up. So,
coworker found a full can of beer under Ron's desk.
Damn it, Ron. Always fucking doing shit like this.
Matt!
Damn it, Ron!
Oh, yeah.
This is a violation of the employee handbook. Ron stated it was a gift from his grandfather in China. And forgot it was at the office. So anyway.
Oh, man.
Take another look. Yeah, yeah. That beer brand is Suck It Draft, if you haven't looked. And
that is
comically oversized. Can you scroll back up there to the one where he's got it in his hand?
Yeah.
It is comically oversized. Yeah, there is no beer that exists that is that big.
Yeah, Chinese people aren't that big. They're small, agile creatures. People, sorry.
So as you see here, this was a good thing they didn't open it.
Oh, man. I just, like, what? Like, why would you bring that to work, though? He left. Wait. Did he get? Did his dad send it to him at work or something?
No, he just made that story up. Frankly, I think he just needed a little relief in between TPS reports and pointless meetings.
Yeah, I'm surprised though. Whoever made that pocket mouth, that's some good detail on there. Look at the little wrinkles in the lips and everything. That's not bad.
I wonder if it's cast from a particular mouth.
Oh, probably.
It's probably Ron Jeremy's mouth, some dude's mouth.
What's her name from Full House?
Jodie Sweetin.
Jodie Sweetin. I never knew her. I suck at names.
You know, she's like 32 and has had like 3 kids.
Really?
Yeah, 32 or 33.
Photoshop does what? No, I'm just joking. I'd still fuck her.
Yeah. Whatever. Well, hell, Candace Cameron Bruce? I don't know. Whatever. She's Candace Cameron. She's
the one that's DJ, right?
Yeah.
No.
Kirk Cameron's sister. Another fucking religious creep.
Are you fucking kidding me?
You didn't know that?
Kirk Cameron?
Yeah.
The guy that did the Titanic movies?
That's James Cameron.
Yeah, I just like
Kirk Cameron was on.
I'm horrible with names. Who's Kirk Cameron?
He was on one of those sitcoms. Was it Step by Step? No, I don't think.
Step by Step. Oh, I loved that show. That show was great. Because my family was just fucked up.
Hang on, I'm having a brain fart. Yeah, growing pains. He was on that.
Yeah, I was having a brain fart too. Yeah, I'm horrible at names. I got to see faces. I just got to.
Yeah, he was Mike Seaver on Growing Pains.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's his younger sister, Candace Cameron. Anyway, she's 40.
Really?
Yeah.
I just saw this Selma Hayek's like 50-something.
Really?
Can't even fucking tell. Jennifer Aniston's 50-something?
Well, Jennifer Aniston doesn't age.
Yeah,
she looks exactly the same as she did when she was on Friends.
Yeah, I think she's like Asian or something, because Asian women, they'll be like 80 years old, won't age a bit, and then once menopause hits, it's just they shrink.
They look like baked potatoes.
Yeah, they just like shrink from like a grape to a prune. It's just
Asian people stay youthful up until one point, and then all of a sudden they look like mystical ancient.
Yeah,
they look like they're gonna tell you how to find the mystical artifact to slay the dragon.
And that's how I feel like when I see an older Asian woman, and I've just like I get this like dark feeling over me. I'm like, I think this lady's like,
this is a side quest.
Ding!
I get a lot of use out of that sound effect.
Well, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. I'm going to give you that one. Oh, man, that's great.
Do it! Just do it!
I got to throw a couple more in here. It's just balance it out.
That's a huge bitch! Those motherfuckers!
That's my favorite. Okay, those motherfuckers. That's my favorite. That's from Deuce Bigelow, Male Gigolo 2. If you haven't seen that movie, or it's Deuce Bigelow, European Gigolo. This is such a great movie. Like, that whole conversation is just so funny.
It is good. Like, my favorite one on the board is this one, and I don't get to use it nearly as much as I'd like to.
Stop breaking the law, asshole!
I know. That's one of my favorite movies from my childhood. Was Liar.
People give that shit as... people have said that's a mediocre movie. I thought it was
a great
movie. Are you
fucking kidding me? That is such a great movie. That's when movies like had meaning to them, but were still funny.
You know what, though? I wonder if maybe it was a bad movie and we're looking at it through rose-colored glasses.
I don't give a fuck. Fuck y'all. Because
you know
what? I'm
sick
of these pedophiles.
You know, I have to wonder. I was listening to this a while ago and on some radio show. I forget what I was listening to, but they were talking about it. It's like, did we know that movies were bad back then? Did we know that a movie could be bad? Seth Rogen was actually talking about it.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. Movies are shit.
I mean, like, The Goonies. Everybody loves The Goonies. Is The Goonies a bad movie? It might have been a bad movie.
But
I think it's a great movie, but it might have been a bad movie.
Anytime you have saturation in something, it loses meaning. It loses quality. And they mass-produce movies so much these days.
Oh, they always did.
You don't... But not really. Like, the Wizard of Oz story about that guy, he had to sell his farm. If the Wizard of Oz failed, he was going to go...
Well, that was long before our time.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. Movies back then used to mean something. Now it's just...
Like, I don't know.
Like
not
that
all
one,
of them.
Like that one guy was saying about, you know, 70% of these people aren't going to see the movie in English. Why do we care if it's good or not?
Yeah, good point.
Like, people... You just mass produce. Like metalcore. Metalcore music used to be so good, and then it just got oversaturated and just...
You know what my problem with metalcore music is? The fucking clean singing. I don't mind a clean singing band. I don't mind a growling band.
No.
Pick one. And if you're going to do it well.
I know, and a lot of people don't. Like, I call it tamponing it.
Yeah, because you stop the flow.
Oh, yeah, you just have this great flow. This great flow of just fucking like, da, 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 and you're like, you know, you want to stab some people because, you know, you hate your life.
But they get really whiny.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden the fucking open chord comes and it's like.
I can deal with clean vocals, but as soon as they get that whiny ass voice, I can't do it.
Like Thrice. Like, hey, this, I think it's called Torch to End All Torches. Great song. Fucking feedback flying into the beginning. It's just like. And then it's like this fucking drum beat comes in and then just fucking throw that tampon in there and plug that fucking hole, dude, and they just ruin the whole song. It's horrible.
You know, I was listening to Google Play Music the other day, and I'm getting bored with everything because I'm old and curmudgeon-y, and I listen curmudgeon-y.
That is a great word.
I only listen to the same bullshit over and over again. Like, you can only listen to so many thrash bands.
Mm.
You know? So I put on new metal first, or their new metal, whatever it was, whatever came out new in the metal world, and it's all garbage.
I know, I can't see
it. Do you ever
it.
Hear of a band called Attila?
Actually, that sounds familiar.
They're terrible.
They probably are.
They're fucking awful.
It takes a lot for me to fucking like a band. Like that one band I sent you. They put a cough in their song. Like,
yeah, is that the same one that has a lyric that I'm damn sure is your filthy fucking French fries?
No, that's Volumes. Like, I was listening to a song, this guy, I swear to God, he's yelling, and your filthy fucking French fries.
Your filthy fucking French fries. Dun, 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 dun.
And then the first,
I don't like the music, but it was awesome.
Yeah, and then you scroll down, the first comment is your filthy fucking French fries. So we're not the only ones. But no, this band, like, this guy is, like, screaming. He's going on about somehow girl broke his heart or some shit, what all metalcore is about. And
I feel my man things.
And then all of a sudden he just like goes, he starts coughing and then turns the cough into a scream. And I was like, that's what you got to do to stick out. You got to be a little bit crazy.
To be fair, Black Sabbath did that first.
Fuck Black. No, I'm just joking. I love Black Sabbath.
Yeah, what the hell, man? That's blasphemy. But you know what? I fucking hate Dio. I'm getting so much shit from that. I hate Dio.
And the funny thing is when he listens to like fucking music on, what do you listen to? Pantera.
I do listen to Pantera. Google Play Music usually.
Fucking Dio. All I hear.
It follows me. It knows. Every station I have has Dio on it. It fucking drives. Like, there's no reason I shouldn't like Dio because I love Iron Maiden. I love Ozzy. I love all those older bands. Judas Priest. They're all like that, but I just can't do it.
I think it's
Dio's arrogance, you know? Like, who's the best singer in the 80s? Ask Dio, he'll tell you.
And it's torture for you. And I just, Google Play knows.
It drives me fucking nuts. Ride the tiger! You can see his stripes, but you know he's clean. Don't you see what I mean? No, Ronnie, no one sees what the
fuck you
mean.
Because not everyone's doing heroin.
God bless you. I'm sorry, you know, props to you. You're up in heaven right now. You led the good fight, but dude, no one saw what you mean.
Nah.
What the fuck's a holy diver? What the fuck's a rainbow in the dark? You're just a rainbow in the dark!
I have no idea.
You're just on fucking crack.
Yeah, probably. I don't know. I also remember watching a video where he says he's the one that created the devil horns.
Yeah, he did.
Is it?
I'll give it to him.
I thought it was him or the guy from... I thought it was Lenny from Motorhead that did it.
Lemmy, no. Lemmy doesn't do that.
Are you sure?
No, he's never.
There was a huge controversy about this.
No, Gene Simmons is the one who claimed he did.
That's
because
what it
of
was.
The way he plays bass.
Yeah, that's the way it was. Like it was this. A fight between Dio and Gene Simmons, and they were arguing.
It's because of the way he plays bass. It looks like.
Yeah,
it. I'm doing this under the table. You can't see me. But he
what are you
plays
doing under
like
the table?
This. Hey.
Beat that shit like it owes you money.
The waveform on your computer looks great for that.
Oh, yeah, it does. Nah. Looks like a... yeah, it does. anything else for us?
Oh, yeah.
To talk about?
Yeah, I got all sorts of funny shit.
Oh, great.
So besides the man who put the pocket pussy, we got another one here. It's another Adventures of Florida Man. Here, hang on. Like, I might even be able to make this echo. The Adventures of Florida Man.
Yeah, did a little bit.
That worked pretty good. He stops a street fight by running everyone over.
That why not?
It was a 3 a.m. street fight outside of a bar in Tampa, and Florida Man ran everybody over. They're all fighting in Nissan Altima Park against a curb. They're all sitting there right around it, and this guy was involved in the fight, was trying to leave, and he failed to complete his U-turn down the narrow street and just took them all out.
Oh, my God. People in Florida, like, they have to do some kind of study down there to find out what the fuck's going on. It has to be the water. Like, it just... Was it Orlando?
Tampa.
Okay. Because like, I lived in Orlando. It's pretty nuts down there. It's...
Of all the ways to take out somebody who's stepping on your fucking shit, run them over.
Yeah, like...
Argument over.
Like, Florida, like, the bouncers down there, like, it is like movie shit. Like, I actually... My friend that I lived with, he knew a bunch of people because he worked in a club. And I actually went to the Orlando
Magic... Up in the club.
I went to the Orlando Magic's stadium for a party. And it was fucking insane. It was like something out of a movie. And I don't have nice clothes. So, like, I just went like garbage. I just had a t-shirt and just everyone was dressed up.
Yeah,
and
I'm pretty sure you've worn that sweatshirt for the last 5 shows.
Yeah, I don't care. Fuck it. I got it from a blue box. No, I'm just joking. But I'm walking. There's velvet ropes. We got in because we knew the bouncers or whatever. And
wasn't that a terrible Janet Jackson album?
What?
Velvet Rope.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah. That's why it was good. And there's fucking flames shooting up and shit. It's insane. And we get in the elevator and they have a guy standing there with his hands in his thing. And this is when you know I look like shit. When the elevator guy tells me I look like shit.
Damn.
Like he goes, I see you dressed up today. I go, just press the button like you're supposed to. So we get up there and we go. And it's on the top of the stadium where the Orlando Magic play. And there's the security there were security with full tuxedos on with guns.
Like, oh, good.
That's the way Orlando is. And there's a lot of nightclubs that they have guns. And Florida, like, Florida has a law where bartenders are allowed to drink. Like, in Pennsylvania, you're not allowed to be a bartender and drink. Right. In Florida, you're allowed to. And it was just insane. Well, like,
most
Florida,
places you're allowed to, but Pennsylvania's back-ass woods when it comes to that.
Yeah.
And where, like, alcohol laws are so behind the way the time.
And, like,
here.
My friend at the time, he worked for a bar that the guy that created 3M calculators owned.
Really?
Yeah, and he said he used to go there and just buy... Like, they charge you like $300 for a bottle of liquor, and you just sit in a VIP room and just do a bunch of drugs with everyone. But fucking Florida's nuts. Like, I was uncomfortable because I'm the kind of guy where I go in and I don't care if the floor is dirt or mud in a bar. Just give me a fucking beer. But in Florida, it's all presentation and looks and just everything, and it's like really uncomfortable. I even got made fun of by the elevator man.
The only club that's in our area here, I actually got turned away from because I was wearing a flannel shirt. Now, this is back before hipsters were a thing, and it would have been cool.
No, right now, yeah.
Yeah, where it would have been cool for me to be wearing a flannel shirt. But I got talked into with these group of girls. This is a long time ago. They wanted me to go to this club with them. And I'm standing in line, and the bouncer's like, you're not getting in here with these clothes on. I'm like, okay, peace out. See you. I had no intention of going there to begin with, but I got talked into it. I was wearing the flannel shirt, and they're like, yeah, you can't wear that in here. I'm like, why?
Yeah. Who fucking knows? I don't know. I was wearing camo shorts one time. They wouldn't let me in. I don't know if they thought I was like a Cuban refugee trying to kill someone. I don't fucking know. I don't know, because I know down there, we actually had a friend that went down there, and the travel agents tell you you're not allowed to wear camouflage anywhere down there because that's a sign of the military, and it's supposed to be a military-only thing. So they tell you straight up, don't pack any camouflage.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, damn, nobody around here would even be able to walk down the street.
I know, all the hardcore kids with your tall tees and fucking camo shorts.
Oh, I was more talking about how the people who like to hunt for sport and wear a lot of camouflage.
Nah. Pennsylvania hardcore.
Pennsylvania hardcore. We're not hardcore.
Nah,
maybe in Philly, not here.
Nah. Did you? Did that guy kill anyone?
I don't know. It didn't say.
Oh, damn.
That's speaking of Florida, now we've got an adventure. A Florida woman accused of shooting a house guest at house guests who stayed too long. I don't see a problem here.
See, and this is a thing where you can't let things stay in. Like, she was probably a really nice woman and was like, I don't know how to tell this guy. And then held it all in and just blew her lid.
Well, here's what happened. So she had her house guest stay for a little while. And she decided that she would get a shot or a handgun and started shooting at their feet from the doorway of the home.
Oh, so she didn't actually shoot him. She was just
No, she hit him in the leg.
Oh, okay. I thought she was like Yosemite Sam and like how he bangs and shoots at night.
Mm-hmm. So here's what's even funnier is she shot her own boyfriend in the leg too somehow during the shooting.
Oh my God, what was she like spinning it around?
The boyfriend allegedly told authorities that he told Savelle that if someone is told to leave their property three times, she's to get the gun and shoot it at the ground. If that doesn't work, she's supposed to shoot them in the leg. Well, she did.
She was following directions.
And she shot his ass in the leg too, apparently.
She was following her. Can you blame her? Who told her this? A cop or something? Or
no, her boyfriend.
Ah, her boyfriend. Yeah, boyfriend. Man, that's. I don't know. A lot of people just blast you because if they don't kill you, then you can show up in court.
It's hard to seal me or sue me when you're dead.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, I got one little more short one before we go.
Okay.
So this guy stole $4.8 million from his employer between 2008 and 2015. You'll never guess what he spent $1 million of it on.
What?
A bad Clash of Clans game called Game of War. Oh my God. That's the one that has Kate Upton all.
Who's Kate Upton again?
This lady right here.
But
model.
Who is she? What is she playing?
She's a model.
Oh, she's a model?
Yeah.
Fucking slut.
Yeah, she's in. Because she's a model. She's a slut.
That's what I call women I want to have sex with. You dirty slut. Moving along.
Why don't I have a girlfriend, Jay? Gee, I don't know.
I don't have a girlfriend because I don't let her out of the basement. Actually, it reminds me, I gotta go to the fish market. I gotta feed her later.
Moving right along.
Am I joking?
I don't know. Anyway, so this guy, he used a combination of embezzlement and money laundering, and he spent $1 million.
Fucking these pay to win games are fucking retarded. Oh my God. I really like
We're talking about the guy who embezzled nearly $5 million from his employer and we're worried about the pay to win game.
No, I'm just pissed. I hate play to win games. It is fucking bullshit.
Yeah. If you're gonna embezzle money from your employer, spend it on something.
No,
more worthwhile.
Like when I first heard it, I was like, wait, what fucking game costs $1 million? Then I realized it must be a play to win game like Clash of Clans or something. And it's like these fucking games are set up to where you can't win unless you pay a lot of money. And that's why you see a lot of them with actors like Kate Upton and Arnold Schwarzenegger. Because they're fucking getting rich off of you
Mobile
being
Strike.
A... Yeah.
We're going to play Mobile Strike.
They get rich off of you being a fucking retard. The whole game is designed that you cannot win or do good unless you pay money. The game's free. That's how they get you.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're just like, oh, you know, to do this, you have to pay this. And it's just like, I fucking hate it.
I hate free-to-play games.
Ugh. It just fucking drives me nuts. Ugh.
All right. Well, I think that's all we got time for today.
Yeah, I'm done. I'm done. Fuck you. Game over. And I didn't pay for it.
And remember, we're not advocating that you go out and send a bunch of nasty emails or phone calls or contacts
God,
on Facebook here.
You want this guy to die, don't you?
No. I do not. I do not. But if anybody were to want to exercise their First Amendment rights to tell this idiot how much of a fucktard he is, the links will be in the description below.
Oh my goodness, well, he's gonna die now.
He's not gonna die.
Someone's gonna cut his scrotum off and feed it to him.
Nobody killed him yet. Trust me.
Be like,
he's not
is
gonna...
this real? Is this real? Like that old wrestling. Did you ever see that?
Dude,
interview?
If that happens, you're gonna be a suspect.
Did you ever see that wrestling video where he's interviewing him? He's like, "What's this I hear about? The wrestling isn't real." He just bitch slaps him right in the face. He's like, "Is this real?"
All right, man. Everybody, give us a like, give us a thumbs up, share to your friends, review us. Fucking go to Patreon and spend some cash on us if you think we're worth it.
Yes, and stay tuned next week. We got the Christmas special. Everyone have a good night. Thank you very much.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.